So the next two things are two assignments here. So we set C equal to B, and we set U equal to T. And both of these lines are actually doing very similar things. They're taking the value of B and they're copying it. They're taking the value of the thing on the right-hand side and copying it into the location on the left-hand side. So this is going to take the value of B and store that in C. So the value of B is 7. So the new value of C after this line executes is 7. So that's pretty straightforward. That's what we're used to. Now we set U to be equal to T. So we take the value of T and we copy it into U. And because T is a pointer, this means that U is now also going to be a pointer to the same thing that T points to. And what's really happening under the hood here is that the value of T, which as you'll remember is the address of A, that value of T is copied into U. So now the value of U, like the value of T, is going to be a pointer to A. And it's important to notice here that U is not a pointer to T here. U is a pointer back to A because the value of U after this assignment is going to be the same as the value of T. So now when we print C here, we're going to be printing the new value of C, so that's going to be 7. And then we're going to dereference U here, and U is now a valid pointer that's pointing to A, and so we're going to get 42. So it's worth taking a minute to think about these last two lines and see if you can identify what is going to happen with these last couple sets of lines of code. So in these lines here, this is going to set A to 8. So that's basically going to change this 42 to an 8. We are going to set B to 9, so that's going to change this. Note that that does not change C, right? So we had copied B into C here, but that doesn't make C a pointer to anything, right? That just means that C has the old value of B, and now we've assigned a new value for B. However, we have two pointers to A, right? And so both of them now are going to be, if we read through them, both of them are now going to be pointing to this new value. So when we run this print statement and we print B, we're going to get 9. When we print C, we're going to get 7, but both star T and star U are going to give us 8 because they're both just pointers to A. And so we can, whenever we change A, we will have access to that new value through both T and U. And hopefully now you can see that when we assign through T here, we're now going to be dereferencing T. And this is actually a hidden assignment to A. And that's part of what makes the pointers in C a bit difficult to reason about, because you know there's nothing immediately apparent about this statement in isolation that implies that it's actually changing A. And so that's why it can be difficult to reason about code that uses pointers. So that is in fact what happens here. So this changes A to be 123 because A is the thing that T is pointing to. So now when we print out A, we're going to get 123. B is still going to be 9. C is still going to be 7. And then both T and U are still pointing to A. And so we're still going to get 123 for both of those. So hopefully this exercise has been useful in thinking through how pointers work. I'll include a link to a tool, an online tool called Python Tutor. Contrary to the name, it actually handles a lot of different languages, and it does handle some subset of C. And so I will include a link below this video to this particular example in Python Tutor so that you can follow along there and see what the diagram looks like there. It's a little bit different than the way that I draw it, but in essence, it's the same. And so you can use it to sort of check your answers. So I would encourage you to come up with examples on your own and try to work through them on paper, and then you can check your answer using Python Tutor.